East Tennessee is home to two of the fastest supercomputers in the world, Jaguar and Kraken. These high-performance systems help solve the world's most challenging problems by running simulations of what might happen in the real world. Jack Dongarra, Distinguished Professor of Electrical Engineering and Computer Science at the University of Tennessee, Knoxville, knows the power of these computers well. He puts together the much-anticipated biannual Top 500 list, which ranks the top 500 fastest supercomputers in the world.
Supercomputers are critical for national security issues, and they make fundamental contributions to the economy and the competitiveness that we use in engineering and manufacturing.
Speed is integral to making supercomputers super. Right now, their speed is measured in petaflops. A petaflop is 10 to the 15 calculations per second. Jaguar is currently the second fastest computer in the world, operating at 2 petaflops. To put that in perspective, you would need 3 Neyland stadiums, each full of 100,000 people with interconnected laptops working simultaneously on a single computation to equal the power of Jaguar. But that power is not enough. Today, full simulations can't be completed for many types of problems. Science needs more power, more speed, more memory, or scientific advancements will taper off. Supercomputers need to be taken to the next level. This level is called exascale.
These science applications have stepped up and said, in order for us to do the kinds of problems that we can't do today, in order for us to do them in the future, we need exascale computing.
Exascale is 3 orders of magnitude higher than a petaflop. It is 10 to the 18 calculations per second. That would be 3,000 Neyland stadiums full of 100,000 people working simultaneously on interconnected laptops on a single computation. The task is so important and so challenging, computing leaders who would normally be competing to build the fastest supercomputer are coming together to draw a roadmap for the next generation of supercomputers. Leading this international effort is Dongarra.
We can't wait for the exascale machine to be delivered and then start thinking about the software and the algorithms. The exascale machines are going to be radically different than the kinds of systems that we have today. And we have to have the techniques and the software that will allow us to effectively use these computers on the most challenging science problems that we have of that day.
Dongarra says exascale computing is crucial to science advancements, national security, and the economy.
It's also critical, it's a fundamental thing with respect to the economy and the manufacturing of various goods and technologies in the U.S. So if we think about companies that have these high-performance systems, they're using them really to develop better products.
Achieving exascale is hampered by cost and technology. But Dongarra circles the globe several times a year, meeting with the brightest computing minds around, and feels confident they will achieve 10 to the 18 by 2020. And the world will be better for it.